Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Wassalatu wassalamu ala Sayyidil Mursaleen Amma ba'd fa'audhu billahi minash shaitani wajim Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim Salatu wassalamu alayka ya Rasulallah wa ala alika wa ashabika ya Habiballah Salatu wassalamu alayka ya Nabiyallah wa ala alika wa ashabika ya Nurallah. My dear Islamic brethren and viewers of Madani channel, once again we say marhaba to our silsila, welcome to our silsila, the pathway to success. And today, alhamdulillah azawajal, we are discussing also another beautiful pathway to success, and that is the excellence of showing soft-heartedness, to be soft, to be kind, to be merciful. First and foremost, let us make some good intentions. As our Shaykh Tariqat Amir al-Sunnat always, in every silsila, at every occasion, Islamically permissible occasions, he is telling us to make intention for good deeds. And he quotes the beautiful Hadith Mubarakah that Piyari Aqa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam has mentioned that Niyyatul Mu'mini khayrun min amalihi. Intention of a believer is greater than his action. So alhamdulillah azza wa jal, I am making intention that I am doing for the sole pleasure of my Rabb Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And you also make intention that you are also listening, and inshallah azza wa jal, for the pleasure of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Whatever madani pools we get, we try to be practical upon it. We try to diarize, because diarize means to memorize. Inshallah azza wa jal, we hear the name of Allah, praise Allah in the form of azza wa jalla, in the form of subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. When you hear the attribute or the name of the beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, recite durood, salawat upon the beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. Inshallah, tilawat of Quran will be heard. Make good intentions for the recitation of Quran. Try to be attentive when you're listening to the Quran. When the praise of the beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam is coming in the form of naat, try to join inshallah azawajal in the praise of the beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. Naat khan will also get thawab. You will also get thawab in your account inshallah azawajal. So there are many beautiful intentions one can make when, alhamdulillah azza wa jal, attending these type of mafils or listening to any silsila on Madani channel or any Islamically permissible gathering, always make good intentions. Shaykh Tariqat Amir al-Sunnat, in his famous book Faizan al-Sunnat, chapter Faizan al-Durood al-Salam, Beneficence of Reciting Durood upon the Beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, it gives a beautiful hadith mubarakah that Piyari Aqa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasalam has mentioned that if you forget something and you wish to have recollection of that which you have forgotten, the beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam said, recite durood upon me. Inshallah tabaraka ta'ala, with the barakat of that durood, inshallah azza wa jal, you will have recollection of that which you have forgotten. How many times we forget something? You know, we always thinking, Ya Allah, it was just in my mind for little while ago. I can't recollect, I can't think, I don't know where I left it, I lost it, I just can't think for this moment. Why don't you just think about reciting durood upon the beloved Rasul alayhi sallam? Think about Gumbad-e-Khazra, the beautiful dome of Madina Sharif, and recite durood paak upon Aqa sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Inshallah tabaraka ta'ala, you will have recollection of that which you have forgotten, inshallah azza wa jal. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad, salatam wa salam alayka ya sayyidi ya Rasulullah. Our Qari Sahib, inshallah, will recite few verses from the Holy Quran. Please listen attentively. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذا ما أنزلت سورة نظر بعضهم إلى بعض هل يراكم من أحد ثم انصرفوا صرف الله قلوبهم بأنهم قوم لا يفقهون لقد جاء عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف فإن تولوا فقل حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم أمرت بالله صدق الله العظيم
ما شاء الله سبحان الله My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel now we shall hear the praises of the beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam in the form of Naat-e Rasul صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم صلوا على الحبيب صلى الله تعالى على محمد
يا شهنشاه أمم چشم کرم يا شهنشاه أمم چشم کرم کیجئے آقا کرم چشم کرم کیجئے آقا کرم چشم کرم بولو یا شہنشاہ امم چشم کرم کیجئے آقا کرم چشم کرم کربلا والوں کا صدقہ یا نبی کربلا والوں کا صدقہ یا دور ہو رنج و الم چشم کرم دور ہو رنج و الم چ چشمِ کرم چشمِ کرم چشمِ کرم یا شہنشاہِ امم چشمِ کرم کیجئے آقا کرم چشمِ کرم چشمِ کرم اپنا غم دو اپنا غم چشمِ کرم بولو یا شہنشاہِ امم چشمِ کرم کیجئے آقا کرم چشمِ کرم میرا سینہ ہو مدینہ یا نبی یا نبی میرا سینہ ہو مدینہ یا نبی ہاں یا نبی چشمِ کرم کاش ہو ایسا کرم چشمِ کرم کیجئے آقا کرم چشمِ کرم کیجئے آقا کرم چشمِ کرم دو بقی آقا بقی اب تو بقی ہو کرم آقا کرم چشمِ کرم موت آئے کاش طیبہ میں مجھے عذبہِ خاکِ حرم چشمِ کرم لکھ سکے عطار نعتِ آپ کی آپ کی لکھ سکے عطار نعتِ آپ کی چشمِ کرم دیجئے ایسا قلم چشمِ کرم چشمِ کرم چشمِ کرم یا شہنشاہِ امم چشمِ کرم کیجئے آقا کرم چشمِ کرم
سبحان اللہ صلو علی الحبیب صلی اللہ تعالی علی محمد My dear Islam brethren and viewers of Madani channel The pathway to success Today, inshallah, as we discussed in the beginning, we will be talking about the excellences of soft-heartedness, the excellence of showing mercy, the excellences of showing leniency. You know, always we are faced with many difficulties in the dunya. and we meet up with many different types of people. And we always say, for example, he's a person with a very soft heart. Or they are that type of nation which has a very soft heart. They show a lot of mercy. They show a lot of leniency towards them. They show a lot of leniency towards us. We are always hearing these sentences. Subhanallah Azza wa Jal, the best example. Subhanallah, the best example. Mine and yours and the universal beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. He set the highest standard of showing mercy towards the mankind, towards mankind, towards the animals, towards the plants, towards the trees. We cannot comprehend the amount of mercy our Pyare Aqa Sussam. What beautiful examples he set about showing leniency, showing shafqat, showing love, soft-heartedness towards all the creations of Allah Ta'ala. So today inshallah we're going to discuss this topic and get some points from our mashallah Madani Islamic brothers. And they're going to try to give us some input about the excellences of this beautiful topic, the excellences of soft-heartedness, the excellences of showing mercy. So inshallah first we'll go towards our Islamic brother and hear something from Quran Majid. What does Allah Ta'ala tell us about soft-heartedness, about mercy?
There's many, many things which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered us to do in the Quran. From those things, there are some which Allah azza wa jal has ordered us to encourage one another to do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered us to encourage one another and to help one another, to enjoin one another in performing certain actions. These are actions which we not only do as individuals, but also as a Muslim community, as a Muslim nation, we should help one another in performing. In Surah Al-Balad, in verse number 17, Allah Azza wa Jal says, those who help one another, enjoin one another, encourage one another in patience, and those who help one another in mercy, in showing kind-heartedness, in being soft-hearted to one another. So this concept of mercy is a concept which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants the believers to encourage amongst ourselves, in our communities, in our societies, in our homes, and as a Muslim ummah. And our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent to this world as a mercy for all the universes.
Subhanallah.
Allah Azza wa Jalla says in Surah Al-Anbiya, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ.
Subhanallah.
O my beloved sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we have not sent you except as a mercy to all of the universes.
Subhanallah.
Allah Azza wa Jalla describes himself as Rabbul Alameen, the Lord of all of the universes. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, the mercy for all of the universes. So whoever Allah is Rabb for, our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is Rahim.
Subhanallah.
Mercy for. And there are many, many other narrations, and especially with the meaning, with the similar meaning to this verse, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam actually said to the companions, وَإِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ رَحْمَةً, that I was only sent as a mercy. This was my purpose, to come into this world and to spread mercy amongst creation.
If we go to the life of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this rahmat, rahmatul lil alameen, is the mercy of the alameen. He set the examples for that as well.
Subhanallah.
He shows the mercy in each and every step of his life. And there are the ahadith and there are the examples how he treated with the animals, how he treated the old, how he treated with the woman and the others, with the mercy. There's a hadith pak in Bukhari Sharif. Aqil Alam sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that I stand up to lead Salat with the intention of prolong it. Then I hear the crying of an infant and I shorten the Salah because that it should make the trouble for his mother.
So such incredible mercy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even for children. You know, in one narration he mentions that once the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was kissing some children, you know, yes, showing affection, showing love for them, and a Bedouin, a villager, came from outside of the city, and he said, you know, you kiss the children? It was something amazing for him. You couldn't believe it. You know, you're kissing children. We don't do that. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied to him and said, if Allah azza wa jalla has taken mercy out of your heart, what can I do for you?
Allah.
But this is, if you have mercy in your heart, you will show this love to children. You know, play with them, you know, we can think about this in our own situations.
Viewers of Madani Channel, MashaAllah, Azrael, our Islam brother, giving us such beautiful example. Even children at the time of the beloved Rasulullah making noise at the rear of the masjid, he's basically thinking about what difficulty the mother will be going through. That if I lengthen my salah, mother will be in difficulty, child is crying. So Pyare Aqa Sahib showed so much of mercy, so much of shafqat, so much of love, shows so much of leniency that beloved Rasulullah shortens his salah. Allah. Imam Hussein radiallahu on the back of the beloved Rasulullah, beloved Rasulullah lengthens his sajda so that no hurt, no difficulty must come to his beloved grandson. These are what beautiful examples and what standards our beloved Rasulullah has said. This one beautiful hadith mubarakah that Hazrat Sayyidina Abdullah bin Mughaffal radiallahu anhu reports that Pyare Aqa Sallallahu said, undoubtedly, Allah Azza wa Jal shows mercy. Allah Azza wa Jal shows mercy. And Allah Azza wa Jal likes mercy. Allah Azza wa Jal bestows upon his banda, upon his servant, because for showing mercy. He bestows special mercy. Allah Ta'ala bestows upon his banda because of showing leniency. Allah Ta'ala shows his special mercy upon him that he does not bestow for strictness. So Allah Ta'ala loves those people. Allah Ta'ala loves mercy. Allah Ta'ala shows mercy. And Allah Ta'ala shows mercy upon those people who show mercy.
You know, Aslam, you know, every Muslim, every believer wants Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala to shower mercy on them.
Yes.
You know, we all want Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala to be merciful to us. Allah Azza wa Jalla is Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, the most merciful, the most compassionate. And we all feel that, you know, we all have hope in the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jalla. And as believers, we should have hope in the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jalla. But we must remember that if we are merciful to others, Allah Azza wa Jalla will be merciful to us.
Subhanahu.
If we want the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jalla, then we must show mercy to others. In one narration, which is narrated by Imam al-Bukhari, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, it stated that the beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "La yarhamu Allahu man la yarhamu an-nas." That Allah Azza wa Jal does not show mercy upon the one who does not show mercy to the people.
Allah.
And in one other narration, which is reported in Abu Dawood Sharif, it's narrated that the beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ar-Rahimuna yarhamuhum ar-Rahman. Irhamu ahl al-ard, yarhamkum man fi sama." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah Azza wa Jal shows mercy on those who are merciful.
Allah.
Show mercy to the people of the earth, and the owner of the heavens will show mercy to you.
You know, viewers of Madani Channel, you're talking about, you know, mercy. You know, our beloved Rasulullah showed mercy to the human beings.
Allah.
Our beloved Rasulullah showed mercy to the animals.
Wow.
Our beloved Rasulullah showed mercy towards the trees. So many things our beloved Rasulullah showed mercy to. He showed so much of shafqat, so much love. That one narration, that one day our Pyare Aqa Sahib was on a caravan. On the caravan, this beloved Rasulullah sees that there's a huge bird. It's circling the caravan. And Pyare Aqa Sahib is looking up. That why this bird is circling? And mashallah, he is the one with the knowledge of the unseen, ilm ghaib. Just looking at the bird, our Pyare Aqa Sahib knows already what is happening. Checks the bird, he asks the companions of the beloved Rasulullah, he's asking his companions, somebody has got some property of this bird? Oh no, somebody has got some property of this bird? So one of the companions of the beloved Rasulullah said, yes, Ya Rasulullah, Azza wa Jalla wa Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, before the journey I picked up the baby of this bird. And I wanted to keep it for myself. So beloved Rasulullah said, you picked up the baby of this bird. You picked up this baby. The mother is looking for his child. So beloved Rasulullah stopped the caravan, told the companion of the beloved, step out, give the mother back its property.
Allah.
And the sahabi, companion of the beloved Rasulullah, took the bird, he placed it down, and subhanallah, the mother comes back. Because of the merciful Prophet, the most merciful Prophet, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the bird comes back and takes hold of his baby. So views of Madani Channel, Allahu Akbar, what a mercy our Pyare Aqa Sahib. And it was a female. She used to sell her body. And one day she passed by a water well and she sees a dog in extreme thirst. And when she sees the dog in extreme thirst, she feels softness towards the dog. She shows mercy towards the dog. What she does, she takes her shoes and she ties up a shoe with some string. She lowers the shoe down into the water well, brings up water with the shoes and brings it up, and then she presents it to the dog, and the dog starts to drink, and the dog eventually drinking, continued drinking until the dog quenched the thirst. Imagine she was a prostitute. She did that thing with Allah Ta'ala did not like. But subhanAllah, just because she showed mercy, she showed mercy. Just showing mercy towards a dog, towards an animal, Allah Ta'ala loved this action so much, Allah Ta'ala forgave her, and subhanAllah, Allah Ta'ala granted her jannah.
This story is in Bukhari Sharif as well. And they in Bukhari Sharif, the different, you know, narrations in Bukhari Sharif, it's reported by a man, that was a man. And then Sahaba Ikram asked the question, when Aqaidu Alam Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told them the story, they asked the question, companions asked the question, what was the question? Qalu ya Rasulullah, inna lana fil bahaim ajran, that is there any reward for us from the bahaim, from the animals?
Showing
mercy to the animal, if we show mercy, is there a reward? So Aqaidu Alam Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, a reward is given in connection with every living creature.
Allah.
If you show mercy, any living creature, you'll get reward for it.
Any living creation.
You know, any living creation.
When we look into the lives of the awliya kiram, rahimahumullah salam, we find that many of them actually stepped onto the path of wilayah. They were given wilayah by Allah Azza wa Jal due to showing mercy. Allah. You know, there's one great wali of Allah, his name was Shaykh Abu Uthman Hiri, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. And he was a great wali of Allah, but it says that, you know, before he became a wali, before he was bestowed with wilaya, with friendship by Allah Azza wa Jal, he was a very, very rich youngster, very, very rich young man. And during his student days, he would walk around with a servant. That's how rich he was. And he would be dressed in expensive silk robes. He was very, very rich. He was one of the richest people of the time. And he was a student. And it says that one day, he was walking along with this servant, and he had this expensive silk shawl, this silk robe draped around him, and he saw a donkey. And this donkey was wounded on the side of the street. This donkey was wounded, and the donkey was wounded to such an extent that crows were coming down from the sky and biting into the wounds of that donkey. Imagine the pain that donkey was in. Now Abu Uthman, this rich young man, he's walking along with the servant, and he felt this softness in his heart, this mercy in his heart towards that donkey. And he immediately took off that beautiful, expensive, decorated silk shawl that he had and placed it over the donkey. Now when he did this, obviously the crows flew away, they had no access to the wounds. The donkey felt some relief, and the donkey lifted its head up and gave a grateful look towards the Abu Uthman. And it states that because of him showing that mercy to that donkey, because of him showing that compassion to that animal, Allah Azza wa Jal bestowed him with wilaya.
Subhanallah.
Made him his friend, his close friend. And then he continued, and he became one of the people who was a means of guidance of many thousands of people of his time. The verse of the Quran that you mentioned earlier, Allah Azza wa Jal says, لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُّمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَأُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. Just an English translation. Certainly, a messenger has come to you from amongst yourselves. Grievous to him is your falling into distress.
Allah.
If you fall into distress, it hurts him. Mm-hmm. And he is always worrying about your benefit, about your well-being. And he is merciful and compassionate to the believers.
Allah.
And there are so many accounts. You know, one story that comes to mind, that once there was an individual, he came to the gathering of the beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to the blessed court, and he said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I've been ruined. I've been destroyed. He was asked, what happened? He said, in the state of fasting, I went to my wife. I broke my fast by going to my wife. And he had come to find out what the compensation was, what he would have to do to make up for that fast. The Prophet ﷺ informed him of the hukum of the Quran, that he must free a slave. He said, Ya Rasulullah ﷺ, I don't have the ability to free a slave. How can I free a slave? The Messenger of Allah ﷺ said that if you can't free a slave, then the hukum of the Sharia is that you must fast for 2 consecutive months, for 60 days non-stop. He said, Ya Rasulullah ﷺ, I couldn't fulfill one fast. How will I keep 60 in a row? Then the Messenger of Allah ﷺ said, okay, if you can't do that, then the next hukum of the Sharia is to feed 60 poor people. He said, I don't have the wealth to be able to feed 60 people. the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so merciful. He didn't get angry, he didn't shout at him, he didn't, you know, be harsh with him. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam just kept silent, asked him to sit down, and then after a short while, a large basket of dates was brought as a gift for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When this basket of dates was brought, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, "Where is the questioner? Where is that man who came?" The man replied, "Labbaik, I'm here, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Take this basket of dates and give it away in charity, and your fast will be compensated for."
Subhanallah.
And then the man said, "Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do you want me to give it as charity to someone poorer than me? Oh my master, I swear by Allah, there is no family in Medina poorer than mine."
Allah.
And then it's so beautiful, the narration states that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَضَحِكَ النَّبِيُّ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam حَتَّى بَدَتْ نَوَاجِزُهُ, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam smiled until his blessed pearl-like teeth began to show.
Subhanallah.
وَقَالَ اِذْهَبْ فَأَطْعِمْهُ أَهْلَكَ, take these dates and feed them to your family, your kafara will be complete.
Subhanallah.
Your compensation will be complete.
Allahu Akbar.
Look at the mercy. The mercy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for his ummah. Subhanallah.
Unka hukm jahan mein nafiz, unka hukm jahan mein nafiz, qabza kul pe rakhate ye hai sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inke میں ہر کنجی ہے, مالک کل کہلاتے یہ ہے صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, رب ہے معطی یہ ہے قاسم, رب ہے یہ ہے قاسم, رزق اس کا ہے کھلاتے یہ ہے صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, باپ جہاں بیٹے سے بھاگے فرماتے یہ ہے, ماں جب اکلوتے کو چھوڑے آ آ کہہ کے بلاتے یہ ہے اپنی بنی, ہم آپ بگاڑے اپنی بنی, ہم آپ بگاڑے, کون بنائے بناتے یہ ہے صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. صلوا على الحبيب صلى الله تعالى على محمد, صلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وصحابك يا حبيب الله.
As we going through with that, with the Ahadith Mubarakah and the practical life of the Allah Prophet صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم, how we can implement that in our practical life? You know, we telling them this. We should have told them, you know, from the inshallah, like how we can implement that, what we face, the problem and the issues, and how we react on that time. Mm-hmm. You know, there's a lot of the practical life. When we talk about the practical and theory is different. So theory, we learn the theory. Now we know, you know, we need to know the practical, how we can practical this.
It's very, very important to think about the feelings of others. You know, a lot of the times, you know, there's a saying, especially in the West, that look after number one, look after yourself only, you know, that, you know, as long as my feelings are not hurt, as long as I'm okay, I don't care about anybody else. But this is not the teachings of Islam. Mm. The teachings of Islam are to consider the feelings of others. You know, to think about what the other person is going through. So if you're faced with a situation where, you know, you might have to sacrifice something for somebody else due to mercy for them, then you do so.
So basically, you know, talking about what the other people pursue from
yeah,
you.
Yeah, yeah. So basically,
not just like you are responsible for your action, but you are
exactly,
responsible for some
exactly.
Action.
So in
actually,
simple
actually
terms,
we are giving the viewers of Madani Channel some very beautiful examples. We're trying to get we're trying to create such a mindset for the viewers of Madani Channel out there that, you know, if you look deep into the lifestyle of the beloved Rasulullah and look towards his, how he showed mercy, how he showed kind-heartedness, how he showed leniency, how he showed muhabbat and love, inshallah ta'ala, we are hopeful that people are going to take examples from that. Actually, I'm coming to one beautiful point, that Hazrat Sayyidina Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu reported that Makki Madani Sarkar, minds and years and the universal beloved Rasulullah has said, the thing that has gentleness, softness,
Allah,
kind-heartedness, mercifulness, has more beauty.
Subhanallah.
The thing that has kind-heartedness, has softness, has gentleness, has more beauty.
Allah.
You know, today's time, we heard from Ulama Ikram, from that our Sharia, that do not sharpen your knives in front of the animals, do not cut animals in front of other animals, do not slaughter animals in front of other animals. Where this comes from? This comes from minds and yours, and the universal merciful Prophet,
sallallahu
alaihi wasallam.
You know, Aslam bhai, he just not only set the example, he also told us the reward for that as well.
Ji.
This hadith pak, very beautiful hadith pak. Ahlul jannati thalathatun, that the people of Jannah will be three kinds. The people of Jannah will be three kinds. Number one, Zul Sultanin muqsitun muwaffiqun, that a just successful ruler. And the second one, وَرَجُلٌ رَحِيمٌ رَقِيقُ الْقَلْبِ, the second man, a man who show mercy to his relatives. And the third one, وَعَفِيفٌ مُتَعَفِفٌ ذُو عِيَالٍ, and the third one, a pious believer who has a large family and refrain from begging.
It's a beautiful religion, subhanAllah. You know, from these examples, Islam even teaches us to be merciful to animals, let alone human beings, even to animals. And you know, the verse that we heard at the beginning, the Prophet ﷺ is rahmatan lil alamin, the mercy to all of the universes. Allah didn't say that he is, you know, a rahmah for the believers, or a rahmah just for people, for all of the universes.
Everything.
And you know, I want to ask you a question, ask the question to the viewers of Madani Channel. Do we want goodness in our lives? Do we want goodness from Allah Azza wa Jal? Do we want goodness for our family? I mean, the answer for every Muslim would be yes. How can we get this goodness? Our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught us in a hadith related by Imam Ahmad in his Musnad, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Idha arada Allahu azza wa jalla bi ahli baytin khayran, adkhala alayhim ar-rifq." That whenever Allah azza wa jalla intends goodness for the people of any household, Allah azza wa jalla enters gentleness amongst them. Allah azza wa jalla makes them gentle. And in one hadith which is reported by Imam Tirmidhi, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever has been given a share of gentleness, he has been given a share of goodness.
Allah.
And whoever has been deprived of gentleness, he has been deprived from goodness. If we want goodness, if we want khair from Allah azza wa jalla for ourselves, for our families, then we must adopt gentleness and be kind-hearted.
There's the same hadith, it's like kind of same lesson with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us, Sayyidatuna Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha, make it compulsory upon you the softheartedness and the refrain from being impolite and immodest. Anything that has politeness in it, make it look elegant. And if anything becomes devoid of politeness, then this creates a fault within it.
Allah.
Make a big difference.
Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal, we are hearing so many beautiful narrations about the mercy of our beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, kind-heartedness of our beloved Rasulullah. Then we heard about animals, we're hearing about human beings, we're hearing about birds. You know, there was a time in the era of the beloved Rasulullah where the beloved Rasulullah used to give lectures from Masjid Nabawi Sharif. And what was the member?
No.
It was only a tree. And Aka Sassam used to continue his khutbahs and continue giving his madani pools to Sahaba Ikram and Ibn, until one day, companions of the beloved Rasulullah made a beautiful mimbar. And when the beloved Rasulullah sat for the first time on that minbar to give his first bayan, Allahu Akbar, then all of a sudden they hear the crying sound, like somebody's crying. And then they realized that that tree, Akasam realized that tree, which he gave all his khutbahs in the previous time, was crying. So Aqa Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, our Pyare Aqa Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, mine and yours and the universal beloved Rasul Alayhi Salatu Wasallam, look at the rahmah, the mercy of beloved Rasul Alayhi Salatu Wasallam even shows to trees.
Allah,
and he goes up the tree and Aqa Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Makki Madani Sarkar Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, strokes the tree, and whatever he says to the beloved, to that tree, Allah and his beloved Rasul knows best. And after a little while, the sound of crying subsides. Viewers of Madani channel, beloved Rasul alayhi salatu salam, the mercy unto the entire universe. Subhanallah azza wa jal set so many beautiful examples for us that we, mashallah azza wa jal, we try to inculcate this into our lifestyle, in every aspect of our life, our family members, our wives, our children, parents, brothers, sisters, at work, at home, on the plane, on the train, on the road, wherever we are, just try to think that in view in any situation that what my beloved Rasul alayhi salam would have done. Just think that moment. Then you will realize that, yaar, I'm missing something. And what you're missing? You're missing that shafqa, that love, that mahabba, that extra leniency, that extra soft-heartedness, that extra mercy that our beloved Rasul spread throughout the entire dunya. So we try to inculcate that, inshallah tabarakhu ta'ala, by us showing that mercy, that little extra mercy, that shafqa, that love, it'll bring people closer towards the deen, bring people closer towards the wealth of iman. Those with iman, inshallah tabarakhu, they will strengthen the iman and come closer towards Allah and his beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam.
Aslami, there is a story of a camel. Please tell us that story.
Okay, Allah. Camel. Once beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, he hears a camel crying. The beloved Rasulullah goes towards the camel and he strokes the camel, and our Pyare Aqa is communicating with the camel, talking to the camel. The camel is saying that, Ya Rasulullah, Azza wa Jalla wa Sallallahu Ta'ala, my owner treats me badly, gives me too much of work. I cannot cope with it anymore, so I ran away from my owner. And he's crying in the bargah of the beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. And beloved Rasulullah called the owner and he discussed the problem with the owner. The owner may tawbah in the barga of the beloved Rasul alayhi salatu salam, that do not take too much work from your camel. Whatever is the limit, use the limit. Don't go cross the limit. And subhanallah azza wa jal, beloved Rasul alayhi salam reconciled the camel back with its owner.
Subhanallah.
So views of Madani channel, trees, plants, animals, human beings, everything is looking towards rahmatan lil alameen, the mercy towards the entire universe. You also, don't look left, don't look right, don't look up and don't look down. Only look towards our beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. Inshallah tabarak wa ta'ala, all your problems will be solved in the dunya, inshallah, in the qabr, inshallah tabarak wa ta'ala. And most certainly this will help us on the day of Qiyamah. So views of Madani channel, it is a humble request, as usually when we're entering our silsila, the pathway to success, this is the pathway to success. The pathway to success is only and only in inculcating the lifestyle of the beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. As beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam says, man habba sunnati faqad habbani wa man habbani kana ma yafi al-jannah. Those who love my sunnah, indeed they love me, and if they love me, they're going to be with me in Jannah, inshallah. So you also want to be with Aqa sallallahu alayhi wasalam in Jannah? Yes, in Jannat al-Firdaus, in the neighborhood of the beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. So keep following the lifestyle of the beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. Keep watching Madani channel, keep attending the Ijtama'ats of Dawat Islami in whichever city you are, in whichever part of the world, South Africa, whether you're in America, whether you're in UK, whether you're in Mauritius, wherever you are, please join the Ijtama'ats of Dawat Islami. Allah karam, aisa kare tujh pe jahan mein, ay Dawat Islami teri dhoom machi ho. Ameen bijahi nabiyil ameen. Sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Sallu ala al-habib. Sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad.
The way to the pleasure of Allah, the way to the pleasure of Allah, the pathway to success, the pathway to success, the pathway to success, success.